So in the past I've showed you how you can use semi-transparent images, like maybe a circle or an hour or something, inside of iMovie to create like an overlay, or maybe in Preview to create an overlay on an image. But how do you create these little semi-transparent images? You can use apps like Photoshop or Acorn or something like that to create them. But not everybody uses graphics programs. And there's an easy way to do it using only Keynote. So let's look in Keynote right now and see how I can create just something like a semi-transparent arrow very quickly. So I'm going to create a simple presentation with a default template, the black template right here. I'm going to get rid of all this text and I'm going to just create a shape. Let's do an arrow here. And just to drive home that this is a semi-transparent image, I'm actually going to go into the format over here and change the border to a line border. Make it pretty thick. Make it, say, red. And then I'm going to remove the fill. Make no fill. So you have this semi-transparent arrow here that should be transparent in the middle as well as outside. Now I'm going to click on the background. When I click on the background, the format sidebar here will show me information about the background, including the color. And I can change the color to no fill. Great. So now, of course, it's still black here because it has to show something. It can't show transparency through your screen. It has to have some color back there. So it is transparent even though we still see black. All we need to do now is go to Export and use Export Images. And I'm going to set it to export in format of PNG. Why? Because JPEG formats don't use transparency. PNG format does. So we're going to use that. We're going to select just all slides. We only have one slide there. We'll just go next. It's going to ask us for a name here, so you can give it a name. But what it actually is going to do, I'm going to move this so it's on the desktop so you can see it. And there I've got a folder now called Arrow. And if I look in the folder, there's an image. And you can see already it's semi-transparent because I'm seeing it on a white background here, not a black background. So let's hide the Keynote there. And I've got this PNG. Let's open up something in Preview just to see how this works. So in Preview I'll just open up a quick JPEG. And I will also double click here to open up this arrow in Preview. And then I'll select all, copy, and I'll go over here and paste it. And there we can see it's a transparent image despite the fact that this was on a white background, because again you can't necessarily show transparency here. Some graphics programs show it as a checkerboard, but Preview doesn't have that. So, but you can see as I copied and pasted it, it is transparent, and I can now resize it and use the arrow here to do all sorts of things. I could have done circles, squares. I could have done a piece of text as well, and then that would be a transparent overlay. So if I go back to Keynote and if I were to delete this arrow, put a piece of text, maybe I want to do it like a watermark or something, you can see it could be useful to actually have this stretched across the entire thing. So I'll make it much bigger. Like that. And now I can export that. Images, and we'll do the same thing, PNG. We'll just do this as Untitled to the desktop here. Now I have an Untitled folder, and when I open that up, select all, copy, paste, you can see now it's a transparent piece of text that I could resize and put maybe as a watermark over this. So I'm able to do transparency using shapes, using text in Keynote, only using Keynote, not using an image editing app, and really easily create these overlays to use here in Preview or in iMovie or any other app that uses semi-transparent images.